Have you ever been turned over while swimming in the sea? Or have you ever seen a boat moved by waves? Or who doesn't know the destructive power of a tsunami? Well, these are only some examples of the pure force that the sea has, and it will never change. Well, the sea is a very important source of energy for our planet. For renewable energy, in fact, well, just look at the climate data, the critical climate data that there are today. Well, renewable energy today is mostly developed in hydroelectric energy or in wind energy, but much less in marine energy, as we can see from the graph, only the 0.1%, so a very small part. Well, we can get it from the sea with mechanical processes like waves, tides, or even sea currents. The problem is that sometimes we need very big instruments with high prices and places of collocation that are pretty rare and with precise characteristics. For example, to get energy from the waves, there is the Palladino generator, which is a kind of big snake floating on the water with cylinder bodies connected with movable joints. As you can see from the picture, the movable joints are lifted up and down by the passage of the waves. And the cylinder bodies, if connected to a generator, can produce renewable energy from the sea. Now, another example, but now to get energy from the tides, it is the one which overworks the raising of a high tide to fill a raised tank. Now, after that, the tank with a low tide canalizes the water into a tube, this tube, and the tube lets the water pass into turbines. So, with these turbines, we can get energy again, renewable energy from the sea. Finally, to get energy, we can get energy even from the sea currents, as I said before. And the principle used here is basically the same used for the wind power plants. So we put big, enormous turbines at a very deep depth in the water, capable of rotating in every direction. Well, another principle thought by my group and I uses the variation of pressure at a fixed depth due to the passage of waves or to a tide. Well, the device based on this principle is made of a cylinder body equipped with a mobile piston and filled with gas. So, when a wave comes on it, there is a variation of external pressure which increases. So the pressure of the gas increases and the piston is forced to move internally into the cylinder, as you can see from the picture. Now, after that, when the wave goes away, the pressure returns normal, so the piston can return to its starting position. Well, yeah, the piston, the cylinder body, if connected to a dynamo, can create renewable energy again from the sea. And, well, this cycle can be repeated every time there is a wave or every time there is a tide. Every time there is a wave with a lower variation but higher frequencies, and every time there is a tide, but now with higher variation and lower frequencies. Well, now, I won't stay here telling you all the advantages of these new types of technologies, because everyone knows what innovation has brought in every aspect of our life. We should always care about our planet, and the global warming is a very big problem for it. In fact, the IPCC, International Panel on Climate Change, a group of 2,500 climatologists, thinks that if we won't reduce our emissions of CO2 of the 80%, our climate will drastically change in less than 5-10 years. So, my group work on that topic because we think, we believe that humans have a great potential and we are still in time to save our planet. So we developed that idea and that project because we think that with these new types of technology and new type of energy, we are building a hope for a better life and for a better world. Thank you.